Welcome to Tanu Science. In this video, we'll learn the answers from NTSC competitive exam in the part of SAT in the year of 2018, question number 121 to 133. Before that, some information. Already we may know that NTSC exam conducted by central government. It has two papers. One is MAT, another one is SAT. Total, we know that 200 marks, 100 marks for mental ability test, then remaining 100 marks for scholastic aptitude test. The scholastic aptitude test depend on the subject oriented, that is maths, science and social science. For maths, 20 marks will be allotted, that means 20 questions. For science, 40 questions will be allotted. For social science, 40 questions will be allotted. So each question carries 1 mark. This 40 mark in science splitted into 3 part. 13 mark for physics, 13 mark for chemistry, remaining 14 questions, that means 14 mark for biology. So in this video, we'll learn the answers from question number 121 to 133. This is in the part of physics. So only 13 questions we will discuss in this video. Question number 121. A car travels from Chennai to Bangalore with a speed of 60 km per hour and returns back along the same path with a speed of 40 km per hour. The average speed of the car is given by. First, car travels from Chennai to Bangalore. So, the speed was 60 km per hour. On its return, its speed is 40 km per hour. Now, what is the average speed? The average speed formula is equal to 2V1 V2 by V1 plus V2. So, one speed you can take as V1, another one you can take as V2. So, 60 kilometer you can take as V1, then 40 you can take as V2 is equal to V1 value is 60 into V2 value is 40 divided by V1 plus V2, that means 60 plus 40 is equal to 6 or 12, 12 4 are 48, so 4800 by 100, 20 will be cancelled. Now 48 unit of velocity meter per second, but here given in the speed in kilometer per hour. So the average speed also in kilometer per hour. So according to this, correct option is third one, 48 kilometer per hour. Question number 122. What will be the percentage change in momentum? What will be the percentage change in momentum of a body when both its mass and velocity are doubled? We know that momentum formula P is equal to mass into velocity. This, if you take as initial momentum, final momentum will be like this. Pf is equal to m dash v dash, because changes in mass and velocity. So mass is doubled, then velocity also is doubled. So Pf is equal, if mass is doubled, 2m. If velocity is doubled, 2v. Then Pf is equal to 2^4mv. So this is Pi is initial momentum. Pf is the final momentum. Initial momentum we can take as in the percentage as 100%. Now change in momentum. So change in momentum, del P is equal to final momentum minus initial momentum. Pf value is 4mv minus initial momentum is mv. 4mv minus m is 3mv. For change in momentum is 3, mv is 100%. So that is 300%. But in question itself they mentioned percentage. So in question they mentioned percentage change in momentum, that is answer is 300. So given option is fourth one is the right one. Question number 123. The displacement time graph for two particles are shown in the figure. The ratio of velocity of A to velocity of B is. So we have to find the velocity of A and the velocity of B in the ratio. Now the given graph, displacement versus time. So from this graph we can measure the velocity. We know the basic concept from the displacement time graph, that slope used to measure the velocity. that slope formula in terms of theta, we know that in max also m is equal to tan theta. M is the slope, tan theta is a slope angle. For particle A, we can write velocity of the particle A, Va, is equal. The slope represents velocity. So already mentioned it, the slope represents velocity. A slope is m. Now slope is the slope for A means velocity of particle A. Va is equal tan theta A. So this will be, you can take theta A. It's A made angle with time axis. Then Va is equal to tan theta A, value is 30 degree. Now Va is equal, tan 30 is 1 by root 3. Now we have to find the ratio only. So Va by Vb. So then we have to find out one more Vb. Vb is equal to for velocity of particle B. This B particle made angle with displacement 30 degree. We know that for right angle, total angle is 90. If this is 30, this is 30, then remaining is 30. For A, angle considered with the time axis. For B also we have to consider with the axis time, so that total angle for B with time axis 60 degree. Now VB is equal to tan for B, angle is 60 degree, that is theta B. So tan theta B value is 60 degree, tan 60 is root 3. Now ratio is VA by VB is equal to VA value is 1 by root 3, then VB value is root 3. Then 1 by root 3 into root 3, 1 by 3. So the ratio of velocity of A to velocity of B is, according to answer, the given option is third one is right answer, 1 by 3. Question number 124. The velocity time graph of the body moving along a straight line is shown below. The acceleration of the body along OA, AB, BC is. So we have to find the acceleration of the body along this OA and OB, then OC. Now first find out acceleration along OA. Acceleration is nothing but rate of change of velocity. A is equal to V minus U. For the time interval you can write T2 minus T1. This is acceleration along OA. In this OA, the final velocity V, this is final velocity, the velocity axis, here A, point A represents final velocity, point O represents initial velocity. So final velocity is 10, initial velocity is 0. So 10 minus 0 divided by T2. Here initial time is T1, final time is T2. So T2 value is 2 minus T1 value is 0. So 10 by 2, if you divide, you will get 5. Unit of acceleration meter per second square. This is acceleration along OA. Next, acceleration along AB. Acceleration along AB 0, because no change in the velocity. Velocity is nothing but rate of change of velocity, but here velocity is always constant, 10. So if the velocity is constant, acceleration is 0. Then acceleration along AC or BC, acceleration along BC. Now same formula, A is equal to V minus U by T. Here final velocity is 10. Sorry, final velocity is 0. X-axis, so final velocity is 0. Here initial velocity is 10. Now initial time is T1 equal to 8. Final time is T2 equal to 10. Now we can substitute in this formula. V value is 0 minus U value is 10, because point B velocity is 10. 10 divided by T2. So T2 value here 10 minus T1 value is 8. 0 minus 10 minus 10. 10 minus 8, 2. If you divide, you will get minus 5 meter per second square. Now the answers, 5 meter per second square, 0, minus 5 meter per second square. According to these given options, the given option, first one is the answer. 5 meter per second square, 0, minus 5 meter per second square. Number 125, two bodies A and B having masses 2 kg, 4 kg respectively are separated by 2 meter. Where should a body of mass 1 kg be placed so that the gravitational force on this body due to A and B is 0? Now we know that according to universal law of gravitation, there is an attractive force between the two particles or objects in the universe. So like that, now consider two body, that is 2 kg, this is object A, then this is 4 kg, this is object B. These two objects or bodies separate by a distance is 2 meter. Now third object or third body we are going to place between the two bodies. At that point, acceleration due to gravitation force should be 0. So at what point gravitation going to be 0? Suppose if we keep any one object here, 1 kg you are going to place here. This 2 kg should not exert force on this. Then 1 kg should not exert force on this. Next 1 kg should not exert force on this. Then 4 kg should not exert force on this. So this gravitation force due to A and B on this 1 kg should be 0. That means force between A and C is equal to force between C and B. Let us consider at x distance 1 kg body is placed. So remaining distance is 2 minus x, that is total distance is 2 meter. Here x distance, x meter distance for 2 kg and 1 kg, then remaining distance is 2 minus x. Now force between this A and C, that is gravitation force, then gravitation force between B and C. We know the formula for gravitation force, G ma mc by rac, because here mass of object A then mass of object C. Here G mb mc by rbc. We know that the denominator distance will be in the square. Now g both the sets going to be cancelled. Now mass of object A is 2 into mass of object C is 1. RAC, that is a distance, distance is x square, is equal to mb, value mass of object B is 4, mass of object C is 1 kg, divided by RBC, that is distance between object B and object C, that is 2 minus x whole square. Now 2 ones are 2 by x square equal to 4 by 2 minus x whole square. Now 2 2s are 4, you can cancel, cross product 2 minus x whole square equal to 2 x square. Now take the square root on both the sides, 2 minus x is equal to root 2, then x, we have taken square root on both the sides. Now 2, this minus x I am going to send that side, root 2 x plus x. Now 2 is equal to root 2 value, we know that 1.414 x plus x. 2 is equal, this x is common, you can take out. So here 1 will be there. 1.414 plus 1. 2 equal to x. If you add together 2.414. Now 2 by 2.414 is equal to x. Now if you divide this, we'll get 0.828 meter equal to x. According to the given options, the nearest one is 0.83 meter. So correct option is second one, 0.83 meter. At this distance, for gravitational force on this body due to A and B is 0. Question number 126, a ship of mass 3 into 10 power 7 kg, this is mass, initially at rest, so that is u is equal to 0, is pulled by force of 5 into 10 power 4 newton, that is force, through a distance of meter, 3 meter, that is displacement or distance 3 meter, taken as S. Assuming that the resistance due to water is negligible, the speed of the ship, let us consider this is ship, the mass of the ship, the given 3 into 10 power 7 kg, initially it is rest, this ship is pulled by force of 5 into 10 power 4 newton, this is F, so that distance moved by the ship is 3 meters, that is S. Now we have to find the speed of the ship. Here force and mass is there, we can find the acceleration. A is equal to F by M. F value 5 × 10⁴ divided by M. Mass of the ship is 3 × 10⁷. 5/3, if we divide this 10⁴, then 10�³ goes to numerator 10⁻³. This is acceleration. The next, we can use the equation of motion to find the velocity, because we know the 3 equation of motion, V is equal to U plus AT, S is equal to UT plus half AT square, then V square equal to U square plus 2AS. In the first 2 equation, they mentioned time, so here they did not give any time, so we are not going to use this first 2 equation of motion. Then third one you are going to use, V square equal to U square plus 2AS. V square is the speed of the ship, U square is the initial speed is 0. So 0 square plus 2 A. Acceleration, we have calculated already, 5/3 × 10⁻³. Then distance, S is the distance moved by the ship, is 3 meters × 3. This 3 going to be cancelled. Now V square is equal to 0 square going to be 0, 5 to 10. So 10 × 10⁻³. Now V square equal to, here 10⁻¹ is meaning −3 + 1 is 10⁻². If we take square root on both the sides, V is equal to 10⁻ 1. Now V is equal to 1/10. So V is equal to, this 1/10 you can write as, according to the option, 0.1. Unit of velocity is meter per second, or unit of speed is meter per second. The speed of ship is 0.1 meter per second. So according to this answer, given option is, third one is right. Question number 127. An electric bulb is rated 220 volts. And 110 watt, this is power. When it is operated on 110 volt, the power consumed will be, so an electric bulb is there, the electric bulb rated at 220 volt and 110 watt. If the same electric bulb operating in 110 volt, what is the power consumed by the bulb? Now two set of reading, P1 is 110 watt, V1 is 220 volt. The same bulb going to be used in this volt, 110 volt, then what will be the power? There is some common value between these two set of reading, then only you can find the P2. Same bulb used, in the same bulb resistance going to be the same. So R is equal to V square by P. This is resistance formula in terms of power. Here P1. Resistance is constant, so we are not going to use a subscription as 1. R is equal to V1 square value 220 × 220 divided by P1 value 110. This 0 to 0 going to be cancelled. 2 11s are 22. Then R is equal, if you multiply, you will get 440 ohm. So resistance of the bulb is 440 ohm. The same bulb will be used in the 110 volt, so that here power formula P2 is equal to, you can modify this power formula, P will go here, R will come to denominator. So P2 is equal to V square by R, that is V2 square by R. Now P2 is equal to V2 value 110, square is there, so 110, one more time, R value calculated 440. 0, 0 going to be cancelled, then 4 11s are 44, then P2 is equal to 27. If you divide 110 by 4, you'll get 27.5 watt. This is the power consumed by the bulb when it is used in the 110 volt. According to this, given option is, fourth one is the right answer, 27.5 watt. Question number 128. In the above electrical circuit, the readings shown by the ammeter voltmeter. So we have to find the ammeter reading and voltmeter reading. Ammeter means you have to find the current reading, then voltmeter means you have to find the voltage reading or potential difference reading. Now first we can find the ammeter reading I. Current formula in terms of resistance is V by R. This is series circuit. In series circuit, current is constant. To calculate the constant term, that is current, the resistance should be total. So the effective resistance should be used. Total resistance should be used here. So total resistance, how will you calculate in series circuit? We know that Rs is equal to R1 plus R2. This is total resistance formula in series circuit. R1 value you can take as 5 ohm. R2 value you can take as 3 ohm. Now R1 plus R2. R1 is 5. R2 value is 3. So 5 plus 3, 8 ohm. So Rs value, that is effective resistance or total resistance value is 8 ohm. Voltage here given 16 volt. Now you can substitute in this formula. I is equal to V. V value is 16. It would be Rs value is 8. So if you divide this, I is equal to 8 are 16. That is 2 ampere. So in the given options, first and third options, there is a 2 ampere. So 10 volt or 16 volt you are going to find out. Now voltmeter reading we have to find out. So voltmeter reading V is equal to IR. In series circuit, voltage is different across each resistor. So across 5 ohm, resistance value is 5. So that V1 is equal to IR1. Because voltage across first resistor, V1 is equal to I value constant to R1 value 5. Because across this 5 ohm, we are going to find out the voltmeter reading 5 ohm into 5. Now V1 is equal to 10 unit of voltage is volt. This is voltmeter reading. So ammeter reading is 2 ampere, voltmeter reading is 10 volt. According to this, in the given options, first one is the right answer. 2 ampere for ammeter reading, 10 volt for voltmeter reading. Question number 129. In the circuit shown, the current in the ammeter is, so you have to find the ammeter reading, that is current reading. I value you have to find out. We know the formula, current formula, I is equal V by R. V here given 20 volt, but R is the effective resistance of the circuit. Now I have to find the effective resistance of this circuit. Here 10 ohm, here 10 ohm, then this is 5 ohm, A, B, C. Now first we will find the resistance, effective resistance in series circuit. This 10 ohm, 10 ohm and series connection, end to end connection. So Rs is equal, you can take this is R1, this is R2, this is R3. R1 plus R2 is equal 10 plus 10, so 20 ohm. Now the circuit will be like this. Instead of these two resistors, we will draw only one resistor. It is simplified as 20 ohm. This is Rs value. This is R3 value is 5 ohm. So A, B. Now this both resistors are connected in parallel. So parallel means Rp is equal to product in numerator, addition in denominator. Here R1 means Rs, R2 means here R3. So Rs plus R3. Now Rp is equal to Rs value 20, R3 value is 5. It will be Rs value 20 plus R3 value is 5. Now Rp is equal to 25 or 100 by 25. If we cancel, we will get 4. So Rp is equal, effective resistance of the circuit is 4 ohm. Now we can substitute in this formula. I is equal to V value is 20 divided by Rp value. We have calculated here 4 ohm. 4. If we cancel this, we will get 5 4s are 20. So I is equal 5 ampere. This will be the ammeter reading. According to this, correct option is the first one, 5 ampere. Number 130, if 5 coulombs, that is Q, of charges flows through a conductor in 2 seconds, this is time, then the number of electrons flowing through a conductor in 1 second approximately. So you are given 2 time, so 1 time we are going to calculate for current. I is equal to Q by T. Now I is equal to Q here 5. T is 2. So if we divide, we will get 2.5 ampere. But in their question, they are asking the number of electrons. That means N, we have to find out number of electrons. So we know that formula Q is equal to NE. Now current formula I is equal to Q by T, rate of flow of charge. I is equal to this Q formula NE. You can substitute here Q is equal to NE by T. Then we can modify this formula for N, IT by E is equal to N. Now I, we have calculated already 2.5 into T. T here mentioned, there are two times, there will be a confusion. Number of electrons flowing through a conductor in 1 second. So to calculate number of electrons, in time interval is 1 second. So T value is 1 divided by charge of electron. It's a constant value 1.6 into 10 power minus 19 equal to N. Then for our convenient, we can multiply with 10 by 10. So 10 into 2.5, 25. 10 into 1.6 is 16. 10 power minus 10 goes to numerator 10 power plus 19 equal to N. If we divide this, we'll get 1.5625 into 10 power 19 equal to N. Then in question, they given the power of 10 power 18. So that 15 point, if you keep point here, 625, it will be reduced by 1. Power will be reduced by 1. So 10 power 18 is equal to N. So approximately one of the mentioned in question. So 15.625 10 power 18. So according to this answer, the given options, second one is the right answer. 15 into 10 power 18 electrons. Question number 131. A stone is dropped from the top of a tower 490 meter high into a pond of water at the base of the tower. The splash is heard after. So we have to find the time. The splash is heard after what time? Given acceleration due to gravity 9.8 meter per second square. Speed of sound, the given 350 meter per second. So let us consider this is tower. At the top of tower, the stone is released to the pond of water. When the stone is falling into the pond, it produces a splash sound. That splash sound going to be heard at the top of the tower. So first time taken by the stone to reach the pond. Next time taken by sound to reach the top of tower. So now two times you have to add T1 plus T2. T1 is time taken by stone to reach the pond from the top of the tower. T2 is time taken by sound, that is splash sound, to reach the top of the tower. Now first we'll calculate the T1 using the one of the equations of motion. S is equal to ut plus half at square. Now we need a time T1. If the stone is dropped from the top of tower, means initially it would be rest. So u equal to 0. For calculating time T1, we can use a subscription here, T1. S is nothing but height of the tower. The given question itself, 490 meter. Now S value is 490 is equal to initial velocity 0 into T1 plus 1 by 2 A. The given acceleration due to gravity G is equal to 9.8, because stone is falling down. So falling down means A equal to G. Now A equal to G, so G value is 9.8 into T1 square. 490, 0 into anything will be 0. Then 1 by 2 into 9.8 into T square. This 2 will come here in the numerator. 2 into 490, 980. 9.8 will come to denominator, is equal to T square. If we cancel, we will get 100. So 100 you can write as 10 square equal to T square. If we take square root on both the sides, 10 is equal to T. That means time taken by the stone to reach the pond is 10 second. That is T1. T1 value. T1 is 10 second. Next you can find the time taken by the splash to reach the top of tower. So that is T2 we are going to find out. We can use the velocity formula or speed formula. Speed is equal to distance by time. We know this formula from basic. Now speed is, you can take as V, distance. So distance means that splash sound should move from base of the tower to top of the tower. So the distance is 490 meter. So distance is 490, time is T2. Speed of sound given in the question itself, speed of sound is 350 meter per second. So your speed of sound is 350 is equal to 490 by T2. 00 cancel. You can cancel the 7 tables. 5 sevens are 35, 7 sevens are 49. Then T2 is equal, T2 will come here, 5 will go to denominator. Then 7 by 5 is 1.4 second. If you divide this, you will get 1.4 second. Now total time t is equal t1 plus t2. T is equal t1 value is 10 second plus t2 value is 1.4. If you add together, you will get 11.4 second. So the splash sound will reach the top of the tower in the time interval of 11.4 second. So according to this, the correct option is first one, 11.4 second. Question number 132, this is conceptual question, direct question. Infra sound can be heard by rhinoceros. So rhinoceros na ganda mirugam. Number 133, among the statements which is are correct, action due to gravity G decreases from equator to poles. So this is earth, this is equator region, this is pole region. This G decreases from equator to poles. So equator to poles, G is decreases. Then decreases from poles to equator. So decreases from poles to equator. We know that at equator, G is low. G is low. At pole, G is high. So what I am going to say, acceleration due to gravity decreases from pole to equator. Decreases from pole to equator. So this only right one. So option B is correct statement. Option 1 is a wrong statement. Next is the maximum at the center of the earth. At the center of the earth, action due to gravity is 0. So this one also wrong statement. So correct statement is option B. So according to this statement, the given option, fourth option is right one. Option B only correct. That is, decreases from poles to equator. Thank you, students.